flash in a hazy glow. My hands, your bones, no soap, we break the scene. One step deep as you fall to me. I clap, we skip a beat. Count one, two, three. Hey guys, it's Andy Rush here, and wow, your girl did a tutorial of this eye look. It's like a fall eye look with this dark look that I've been obsessed with. Guys, this look is so beautiful. I literally envisioned it. I had a vision in my head last night when I was literally in bed, like sleep. I wasn't sleeping yet, but I was just envisioning the fall look that I wanted to do and the style that I wanted to do it. I'm like, okay, tomorrow I'm going to film it. And whatever. And I just filmed it from scratch. I just did it with the vision in my head and it came out better than expected. I love it so much. I hope you guys love it too. This lip I've been obsessed with. Oh my gosh, you guys are gonna find out what it is, but I love it so much. I think it's amazing for fall. And it goes with my new hair, which I am going to be doing like a little review on later. On during the week about this hair. Hasn't even been a week with it, but so far I love it. If you guys like hair reviews, I'm gonna be doing one. This is the look. If you guys like what you see, then continue watching. If you don't, then continue watching and like see how I created it and get some looks. This is super easy. I literally used one brush to do it all because that's how I do all my eye makeup routines. And like majority of the products, it's like a mix of drugstore and high-end, but you could really find the products anywhere. Most of the eyeshadows, like all the eyeshadow basically I use is all freaking drugstore. So you guys, I hooked you up. A girl hooked you up. So yeah, don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. I love you guys so much. And yeah, let's get on to the video. It's been a minute since I've done an eye tutorial or a makeup routine in general. So yeah, I was gonna do a story time, but like it's fall. So you girl gotta get back into the fall gene, back into the Halloween scene. And yeah, that's it. Okay, enjoy.
You already know my intro was long as usual, but I mean, I can't help it. I just love to talk. First thing what I'm going to be doing is pulling my hair back and out of my face just so I can prep for doing my makeup so I don't get any makeup in my hair. And we're just going to be pulling, bringing you guys close so you can see my eyes when I do my eyeshadow. I'm just going to be using the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion all over my lids. It's the only eye primer that works for my lids and makes my eyeshadow last all day. I redid my eyebrows and my foundation, so we're just gonna be focusing on the lips and the eyeshadow. So I'm just gonna be putting that all over my lid and blending it out with my finger. Next, we're gonna be taking this e.l.f. eyebrow palette, and I'm gonna be using that middle color, that tan color, as a base for my eyelids. Next, we're going to be taking this MAC blush in Fever. It's like a pinky, purpley, reddish blush. And we're going to be using the Naked 2 palette brush. And we only use one brush for this whole tutorial. So guys, work with me. And we're going to be packing this on our eyelid as vibrant as we can. I packed a lot on as much as I possibly can. It looked a little crazy, I must admit. But like, this worked. Trust me. Once both of your eyelids successfully look like you have pink eye and they're irritated, then you can move on. Next, I'm going to be using the Sephora Plus Pantone Universe Alchemy of Color eyeshadow palette, and I'm going to be mixing the colors Taupe Gray and Acorn into my crease and blending out all that red I got so it doesn't look too crazy. This next palette I'm using is some random, I think, palette from Claire's. I'm going to be mixing this brick color and this muted purple type of color into my crease. And by blending this into my crease, it adds more dimension to my eyes. And it blends the red with the brown a little better instead of just having like a plain solid brown in my crease, you feel? So I'm going to be using this Avon palette, and I'm going to be using this bronzy gold color. And I'm going to be placing that in the middle of my eyelid. And this added made my like look so much better. It added so much flavor into the look, if I do say so myself. And I just blended it out with my brush and I added a little more, and I just added as much as I felt was enough for this look. So just play around with it. And I also brought some of that gold underneath my lash line just to fill out the eyes a little more and balance them out. Next, I'm going to be grabbing my Naked 2 palette, and I'm going to be mixing the colors Chopper and YDK together as my inner corner highlight. And you'll see how I don't really like the highlight that it turned out to be because it was a little ashy, and this eye look is a little more warmer. So I picked up the highlight I usually use as my highlighter on my cheekbones, and I added that into it because it was a little more warm, and our look is warm. Fall is warm. We want warm colors on our eyes, not cool tone colors like winter. What is a glam look without eyeliner? If you want, you can use brown eyeliner for a softer tone on the eyes. It's really up to you and your preference, but I'm going to be using black eyeliner. The eyeliner I'm using today is the Maybelline Master Duo in 500 Black Liqueur, if that's how you pronounce it. Help me out. And I hate this eyeliner so much. The applicator is so weird. It's one of those applicators that you can turn to make it thick and turn to make it thin. And I hate it because it always messes up my wings, as you'll see. And doing your winged eyeliner on camera is not easy, so I don't even recommend doing it. I'm like never gonna do it again, I swear. But yeah, it turned out horrible, but like, it, whatever, we're just gonna work with it. And cleaning it up because it looks horrible. And they're horribly uneven. Don't judge.
What's a routine with no lashes?
So we're going to be using lashes, duh, and the lash glue we're going to be using is the Kiss glue that comes with the lashes I use, and I don't like this lash glue. I more recommend the Duo lash glue from MAC or whatever. Anyway, the lashes I use are the Kiss lashes in number 11, and I focus the glue on the corners of the lashes so like during the day your lashes don't like, you know, like rise up, because that's so annoying. And wait until the glue is tacky, and I apply the lashes with tweezers, and I just set them into the middle, and then I pull the corners of each lash closer to my lash line, as close as I possibly can. And I push them down with the back of my tweezers.
These haters on my body, shit, come on!
And I'm going to be curling the lashes, and by curling it, it also pushes your normal lash and the false lash closer together. So try that tip. So I'm going to be using 3 mascaras, wow, just to blend my lashes together and to make my lower ones look a little longer. I'm going to be using the Maybelline Clump Crusher, the Miss Manga Mascara, and the Voluminous Superstar Mascara. Bringing back MAC Blush and Fever and placing that on the apples of my cheeks. And then we're going to be highlighting with the bronzy color we used on our inner corners. And prepping for the lips, we're going to be using my favorite lip balm. It's the Carmex lip balm, just the original one. And we're going to be putting that all over our lips and blending it in with our finger, because we're going to be using a kind of matte lipstick. So we're just going to make sure our lips are nicely moisturized. I have fallen in love with this color. Lastly, we're going to be using the Vivid Matte Liquid Lipstick by Maybelline in 50 Possessed Plum. It is so freaking gorgeous, guys. If you haven't tried it, go pick it up. It's like the perfect fall color, and I'd gladly admit I have fallen in love with it. It just turns every look so vampy and beautiful. And that is the end of the tutorial here. Some like awkward clips of me posing. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. I love you guys so much. And yeah, just like watch the rest of these like awkward clips of me posing, but I look cute, you know? Bye guys, see you next week.